Hello and welcome to It Science.
Almost all of us need a caffeine-based drink to kick-start our day. It could be a piping hot coffee or some tea.
During the making procedure, when the coffee and the water both were heated, that means the water and the coffee molecule, they both were set into a jiggling motion. They jiggle like that. The more they jiggle, the more they are heated. And when they collide with the cup of the coffee, with the walls of the coffee cup, then that jiggling is transferred from coffee and water molecule to the walls of the cup, which makes the coffee cup in turn hotter.
The coffee molecules, this one, are jiggling. And when this coffee molecules with greater kinetic energy collide with the walls of the cup, they make the cup molecules jiggle more and more, and the cup walls gets hotter. But the coffee molecules are not in direct contact with the handle of the cup. That's why we can hold this portion, not the walls of the cup.
So heat is not transferred. What transfer is the jiggling of motion from one atom to the other. And when this jiggling is reduced, that is, water is converted to ice, it solidifies, then the random motion of the water molecule eventually stops, not completely, but to a very greater extent. And then the arrangement of the molecules becomes fruits on a crate. They are arranged in a very regular manner. The separation distance between two consecutive molecules are constant, and that is true for every solid.
When water, that is in the liquid form of water, is given heat from outside the water, then the molecules of the water become more vibrant. Their kinetic energy becomes larger. The bonds between them gets vibrant because of their greater kinetic energy, what they have received from external heat source. So if we consider this oranges as water molecule and this toothpick as a bond between this water molecules, then what happens due to the application of heat from outside to the water is these water molecules become more and more vigorous. And due to this vigorous motion, due to this more randomized motion, due to this more vibrant motion, the molecules get separated apart. This bond breaks.
And in steam, the molecules are so much energized. They have got so much kinetic energy that they are far away from each other. Suppose one is here. If I take this one, suppose one is here, it says, I don't know where my partner is.
The situation is something like the grocery shops you find in a very remote village. Suppose if you find one shop here, then the next shop will be about 4 kilometers away from the first one. So if one molecule of steam is here, the other is here. Because when water becomes steam, the volume expands up to 1700 times that of the volume of water.
So basically what is transferred is not heat. It is the jiggling of motion of molecules. The molecules jiggles, and this jiggling is transferred to other molecules to make this one hotter. So it is a misconception that heat is transferred. There is nothing like heat.
My next experiment is to do with an ice cream and a candle flame. I hold the ice cream bar on top of a candle flame for several minutes. After 8 minutes, the portion which was held directly above the candle flame melted significantly. What is happening here? When I put the flame of the candle near a particular portion of the ice, that portion only gets melts. But what happens to the other two sides around. The science behind this melting of ice lies within the conductivity of ice. Ice is a bad conductor of it, which means it is not so much efficient to transfer heat from one place to the other. Suppose this arrangement of biscuits represent the layers of ice. Ice is a bad conductor of it. What happens is the molecules of this first layer gets heat energy from this heat source. That heat energy is converted to the kinetic energy, which is the energy of motion of the molecules of this first layer. They get vibrated, and the vibration is so rigorous and so violent that the bonds between those ice molecules break at some point of time, and then this layer breaks down. So this layer gets separated from the ice block. Now it's turn for the second layer, and the same thing happens for the second layer also. The bonds of the molecules of this second layer breaks due to the heat energy, and the second layer gets separated from the ice block. Now it's turn for the third layer. And this is how heat progresses through the ice block.
So melting of ice is not like reading a newspaper that you can get into any page, any news, any story without any loss of continuity. Rather, it is like reading a grammar book. If you do not have a sense of like parts of speech, or like most importantly tense, then you won't be able to grasp with the idea of voice changes. Is it true that everything I put inside a microwave oven get heated?
I have taken some water inside this paper cup and I'm putting this inside my microwave oven. I have switched on the oven. The water is almost about to boil. You can see the steam rigorously coming out from it. We can also see some droplets of water.
The cup has not caught fire yet. Not only that, it is not heated even. You can easily touch it and put it outside the oven with your bare hand. What saves this paper cup is a miracle substance of nature, water. The specific heat capacity of water is one of the highest in this universe. It takes almost 4.2 joules of it to raise the temperature 1 Kelvin for 1 gram of water, which is enormous. Whereas in case of papers, we require only 1.3 joules of energy to raise the temperature of 1 Kelvin of 1 gram of the paper. So if we have a certain amount of water and the same amount of paper, then the heat required to raise the temperature of same amount, we need more heat for water. Actually, 3 times more heat for water than the paper. Let me illustrate this further. Suppose I have 30 ml of water and I want to raise the temperature of this amount of water by 1 degree Celsius. Then the energy required to raise the temperature of this amount of water is equivalent to raise 12.5 kgs of this weight by 1 meter from the reference level. This episode of It Science, where we discussed some fundamental things of heat, is incomplete if I do not mention about the scientist Ludwig Boltzmann, an emotional scientist who made heat suddenly less mysterious by giving the concept of a randomized motion, vigorous motion of atoms inside any substance, which gives rise to heat. But the time of Boltzmann, the concept of atom was like utopia. People were not ready to believe some equations, some theories, some physics relating to a substance which we cannot see.
Ludwig Boltzmann was a serious patient of mental depression throughout his entire life. His theory of atoms to explain heat received a constant criticism, which aggravates his illness. And during a family holiday near Trieste, while everybody was enjoying at the seashore, he hanged himself inside the hotel room. Thanks for your time.